Lance Armstrong. Everybody who's ever known him says he was doping. Everybody who ever rode with him. Everybody who ever slept with him. Everybody who ever jammed a needle in his taint. They all say he was doping, but not Lance.
After a decade of fighting with the United States Anti-Doping Agency, professional cyclist Lance Armstrong has given up.
Armstrong insists he's innocent, but says he is just tired of fighting.
These things take a ton of time and attention and energy. They suck the life out of you.
That sucks the life out of you? You win a 2,000-mile bike race 7 years in a row, and going to court once a month is too much work? But I suppose this does explain his new Deny Strong bracelet. Look, I don't care that Lance Armstrong was doping. I care that he won't admit it. I mean, look what doping did for him.
Lance Armstrong's physiology characteristics are nothing short of astounding. He's possibly the best endurance athlete in the world. Armstrong's heart can beat twice that of a normal person. He gets almost double the amount of oxygen out of every breath that a healthy 20-year-old would. His muscles can go longer and harder without major fatigue.
This is a guy who had cancer in his lungs, his brain, his testicles. He went through chemo and lost one of his balls, for Christ's sake. And he's getting double the oxygen out of every breath. The question shouldn't be, was he doping? The question should be, why aren't all of us doping?